23rd, and it's been a very busy day, like every day has been for the last 6 weeks. I've actually spent 2 hours today talking with the administrators, physicians, scientists at two of our hospitals, trying to better understand where we are with our testing in the city of Mobile and what the opportunities are going forward. We've learned a lot in the last 6 weeks. I mean, the hospitals have, you know, one of the things that has occurred is that there's been this greater availability of testing on the antibody test as well as the PCR testing. And the data that's being collected now has given us some tools that we didn't have in the past to maybe help predict the future. But there's still so many unknowns about this virus that even those that, you know, are doing nothing but studying it, you know, that's still a lot of unknowns out there. So basically today we talked about what are the things that the city can do to collaborate, you know, with the hospitals. We'll be taking these conversations that we had to the Unified Command to make sure that we're all in sync of what we can do to work with the hospitals to further protect you, the citizens, as we decide what are the next steps in going back to work. Assuming that the governor will release the stay-at-home order or draw the stay-at-home order to an end. And we had very, very informative and fruitful conversations there. You know, yesterday I had the opportunity to go out to Synergy. Unbeknown to me, when I woke up yesterday morning, it was lab week, and I received a text saying, could I do a video and go out there and could I do a video to thank them for all that they've done over the last few weeks? And I told them, better than that, I'll come say thank you. So they gathered the employees with a significant social distancing between each other out in the parking lot. I stood up in the back of a pickup truck and told them what I thought about what they had been doing. And I really just told them, I think that, you know, in decades to come, they'll be telling their children and their grandchildren the impact that they've had on saving lives in the city of Mobile and the state of Alabama. And I said that, you know, you were meant to be where you are at this point in time in your life. And the connectivity of us meeting each other and so forth and working together is just part of what I think is God's overall plan. So going forward from here, you know, the conversation, a lot of it is swirled around the governor's remarks about the lieutenant governor's rollout plan for, you know, starting back to work. The unified command here in the city of Mobile, I think over the next few days, my hope is that we will be coming together with our plan so that when the governor says that you have a green light to go, then hopefully we'll be able to pull a trigger and know exactly what that means for the different segments of our society about how do we start sequencing going back to work. So over the next few days, even though we've been working on it, there'll be a real concentrated effort from our perspective to get that and get it right. I've learned over the last couple of days that even with all the money that our federal government has given away, which in one regard is almost an obscene amount of money when you think about how you compare it to crises in the past, but there are still a lot of people in our community that have fallen through the cracks, that have not received anything and don't have the hope of receiving anything, and that what they're dealing with is that they have run out of any savings they've had. You know, there's no food in their refrigerator. They're scared. You know, and they want to know, you know, when can they go back to work? And I can tell you that you can sit in your living room and watch the news all day long, but you will not get the feel for what's going on out in the community unless you have an opportunity to visit with them face-to-face or talk to them. So today I had an opportunity to visit with some of our cosmetologists and barbers on a Zoom call. A director barber and I were listening to their concerns about, you know, what does it look like for them to go back to work and some things that they're concerned about, because it's one thing for the governor or the mayor to say, well, you can go back to work, but if we say that you've got to provide every one of your customers with gloves or you've got to change gloves between each customer, You know, those gloves are not readily available. And if you say that you've got to have N95 mask, that's not available. So we have got to be very thoughtful about how we allow people to go back to work to protect you, but also to protect them. But in the haste of trying to shut everything down, I know, because hindsight being 2020, that the governor and myself, the health department, they may look at things differently. So we want to do our dead level best to make sure that that we are not allowing, that we're not putting onerous restrictions on those who have the opportunity to start back up. So anyway, those are a couple of the updates that we have. George, do you have anything? I know there have been some questions coming in, and so we'll just flip to the questions and see if I can answer some of those.
We do.
Yep.
Question one from Tyler Fox 10. 1 week from today, the stay-at-home order expires. Dr. Isho with the health department said yesterday he expects it not to be extended. Do you see some businesses reopening on Friday, May 1st?
So, Tyler, I would be disappointed if you didn't send in a question. Even though I hadn't seen you in the last 7 days, I know you're out there thinking about us. Appreciate your question. You know, I would agree with Dr. Isho. I think that there's going to be opening. You know, whether it's whether there's some businesses that can open before that date, you know, would be pure speculation. But I feel fairly confident, and I'm certainly hopeful that the governor will lift the stay-at-home order.
If the order is lifted, we also have a curfew in the city of Mobile. Will the curfew also be canceled?
So, according to the curfew document that was came out of the mayor's office, it said that it will end, I think it's at midnight on April 30th. So that is correct. So it's good through midnight April 30th, and at that time there will be no more curfew in the city of Mobile unless something occurs for us to create another one.
Got a question about testing. You say we have as much testing going on as any city our size, but it's still not widespread for non-symptomatic people. How does that factor into your decision about reopening?
So testing is not going to be widespread for asymptomatic people for a while. I mean, the companies that make the testing just can't produce enough of it quick enough. So we're going to have to make decisions based on the information that we have with the amount of testing that is available. And as everyone knows, but I'll repeat it, we have the antibody test, which is a screening tool. And if you test positive with that screening tool, then you will go to the second test, which is a true test, and that is the PCR test, which is the nasal swab. And we have plenty of those available for the symptomatic people. So we will have to make decisions without knowing that everybody has been tested. But we're not the only city that will be making those decisions, but we have a whole lot more data than many do to make, I think, an informed decision.
Okay, we have one from Justin at Local 15, which is, according to the Lieutenant Governor, coronavirus cases have been on a downswing for the last 10 to 12 days. Is it time to slowly reopen more businesses with safety guidelines in place? Do you agree with the Lieutenant Governor regarding the need to reopen business with limitations?
I think the way you phrase that, with limitations and all, I'd say absolutely I do. Because I think that there are a lot of people thinking about what are the limitations, how do we protect our citizens, but also get people back to work so they can regain their livelihood.
On that note, a couple questions about PPE, protective gear, and the short supply currently. Do you support the need for an ordinance that would, are you concerned about the lack of it, and do you support an ordinance that would require food handlers to wear masks or gloves once restaurants are required or are able to reopen?
So I'm going to take the first one, and it had to do with, am I concerned about the amount of PPE available. That's the personal protective equipment. And absolutely, I'm concerned about the amount that's out there, because there is not enough. Although there is being more produced, there's not enough. And if we mandate that some business, whether it's food handlers or hoteliers or beauticians, have to wear PPE in order to perform their jobs, all you're going to do is you're going to exacerbate the shortage. It's just going to make it worse. And so we've got to be very thoughtful about, you know, can hand washing and other hygiene, you know, make up for the difference there? And I think we would be remiss in being sending a message of being hopeful that businesses will reopen, but at the same time, we put handcuffs and shackles on folks where you can't go to work. So,
got one from John Sharp with AL.com. Yesterday, you pointed to New Orleans as a possible reason for higher coronavirus cases in Mobile. You indicated this came from anecdotal evidence from some early cases. The three southernmost counties in Mississippi have fewer cases in Mobile. Could you be a little more specific about why you think there may be a New Orleans connection? Do you think they were related to Mardi Gras, and were, do you think these were personal or business related?
I think the comment about New Orleans and the connection between New Orleans and Mobile, and saying, well, why didn't the adjacent counties or the counties between the two cities have the same rate of infection? It was personal contact. You pass this disease by personal contact. And so it was individuals that were in New Orleans that were attending functions or dining out or entertainment venues where they came in contact with someone that had the virus, contracted it, you know, and brought it back to Mobile. And unless they stopped at every county on the way, you know, they probably didn't shed it, you know, to spread it. So, I mean, but that's really, we shouldn't hang up on that, and because the virus is going to spread, and so we just got, that's why we keep talking about the social distancing and the things we've got to do to wash our hands, hygiene, and so forth.
One more coming from Facebook. That's from Wendy, who asks about the availability of antibody tests for businesses. Could they receive antibody tests for employees before returning to work? Is that something the city is looking for?
So the answer to that is that while we have, I will call it an abundance of tests or more tests than maybe other municipalities, we're not quite at the point where we can tell every business that we can test all of your employees. And so there will have to be a priority assigned to that. And the specifically, just as to go back through it, it was our first responders that we wanted to test first. Then it was those hospital workers that were on the front lines that needed to be tested. And then it was the sheriff's department and the jail. You know, these are all people that were in populations that had to continue working, the nursing homes. So when it comes to the businesses, there will be a point in time when a business wants to engage and have tests for everyone, depending on whether that business wants to pay for it. There will be some availability, but we're not there just yet.
Just do one more that's kind of about businesses reopening and facing the difficult choice of having to open to survive, and just kind of your thoughts.
Say it again.
The dilemma that a lot of businesses are in, needing to reopen so they can survive, basically, are you sympathetic to that?
Absolutely sympathetic with those businesses that are closed and they've got to reopen in order to survive. If you put yourself in the shoes of a men's clothing store, that has plenty of room for social distancing, and he can't be open, and he looks out at Walmart Target and sees people buying men's clothing, and people are, you know, packed in there. In his mind, he's thinking, you know, why can't I be open? And I get it. And that's why I've said that I think that if a lot of these orders from every state, not just the state of Alabama, if every governor had an opportunity to go back and redo, they would do some things differently. So we can't correct that at this point, but we can try to make sure that we open so that we can level that playing field, and that's what's got to happen. Yep. Well, that's all I have. I will say that we had the opportunity yesterday to do a video with Brad Pitts, similar to the video that we did with Mr. Threadgill at the Mobile County Public School System. And so we'll be posting that video in the next few days. I think you'll find it very interesting of how they have captured this opportunity to get the testing that we now have in the city of Mobile. So thank you, everybody, for what you're doing. Appreciate the time that we've been able to spend with each other. And if you're interested, I would remind you that you could go to the city's website and sign up for the mayor's letter that we write every night, and hope that tells a lot of the things that have happened during the previous day. So if you want to go there, go to the, I guess it's the coronavirus page, and sign up for the newsletter. Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining us here on Fox 10 News. I'm Chelsea Sayasa. Now, we just heard from Mobile Mayor Sandy Stimpson. He says there is now a greater availability for testing in Mobile County. He says a plan is being set in place to reopen the county. Mayor Stimpson says when the governor gives the green light, hopefully they can immediately put that plan into action. He says he had a Zoom call this morning with cosmetologists today to hear their concerns about reopening and to hear about the damage that's been done because of the COVID-19 pandemic. He also says that the curfew should end at midnight on April 30th. That should play hand in hand with the governor's social distancing recommendations. Now, of course, you can find this press conference and more on our Fox 10 YouTube channel and Facebook page. We will break down the latest headlines and keep you updated on the forecast for today on Fox 10 News at 4 p.m. Meteorologist Jason Smith and Matt Barentine are in the studio to help keep you safe. Be weather aware today, y'all, this afternoon. I'm Chelsea Sayasan. We'll see you soon.